Hello, you beautiful game makers! Welcome back. Today I will show you a staple of classic video games, which is blinking. Blinking is oftentimes used to express something appearing or disappearing, and also it's sometimes used for some sort of transparency effect. And it has this really like classical feel to it. So it's really something you should have in your toolbox. So let's roll the intro. What the fuck?
And we're back in Game Maker Studio 2. This is basically the project from last time, at least the base project. Last time was this three-part series where I showed you my tweening concept, like where you could tween pretty much any variable. And this basically is the same concept. So for now, we just have a sprite, which is a placeholder sprite. And this sprite is attached to an object. If we press escape, the game ends. And this object is in a room. Nothing fancy about this. 320 by 180. So yeah, nothing special about this. Okay, so yeah, as I said, it's basically the similar concept from last time. What we will do is we create another object, which is the controller object for the blinking, and we write a small script which we always call when we want to blink a variable, and the controller object then takes over and takes care of the rest of the blinking, and when the blinking is done, the controller object destroys itself. Simple as that. Okay, we begin by creating the script, which we will call blinkext, similar to last time. I will copy and paste what I have prepared, which is, we are using the add params here, so that the compiler later on shows all the parameters we have to supply. Notice that one is in an asterisk, the factor, the pulse factor, and this is because this one will be optional. So I don't actually, if I ever showed you in one of my tutorials, but I will today, which are argument arrays, which, not game ID, which are if you supply arguments in array form, then you can basically supply more arguments than, not supply, but if you use arguments as arrays, then you can have more arguments supplied than you use in your scripts. It doesn't work if you use the normal argument thing. I will demonstrate. So if argument count is greater than 4, which means 5 arguments, because you know we start at 0 as so often in Game Maker. So what I meant by argument arrays, you know those one. Argument 0, argument 1, 2, 3, 4, so on and so forth. If you are using the brackets, the array type, then you can check for arguments which may or may not be supplied. So if you call this script and only supply those four, variable string, and var and duration, but not the optional pulse factor, then the script will still run. Otherwise, it wouldn't run because you would get an error that this needs 4 arguments and only, or 5 in this case, and only 4 are supplied, right? So yeah, that's why we are using this. So if we supply more than 4 arguments, which is 5 and more, then the 5th argument, you know, 0 to 4 is the fifth, then our local variable factor will be this one. Otherwise, if only 4 arguments are supplied, then factor defaults to 1. What factor means and what it does, I will get into this later on. Right, so variable, local variable blinker, which will be our actual instance. Let's move over here. So instance create, we go with depth in this case. If you use a dedicated layer for your controller objects, you can of course use layer. It doesn't really matter because the controller object isn't visible and yeah, whatever. So in this case, we just put it at 0, 0 at the depth of 0. And the object we create is, or the instance we create from the object blink, obj blink fx, which we are going to create afterwards. So this is the controller object. So with blinker. Now we fill in all the arguments. No, sorry. In array form, because if you once choose arrays, then you have to stick with those as far as arguments go. So and var, the final variable. So if basically when we blink, we can always switch between 0 and 1, true or false. And what we are doing here is it's kind of a little fail safe. If we supply something like the end variable should be 2, then it defaults to 1 in this case. So we just make a statement here. So if argument 2 is bigger than 0, so if it's basically everything bigger than 0, similar how true and false work, then this one is true, so it's 1. If it's 0 or smaller, then it's false and equally 0. And yeah, I hope you get what I want to say. And the duration, how long in steps it's going to take, which is argument 3. Boom. Let's make this a bit bigger. Like this. So the blink start value, not dink, blink. It's the same owner is the ID. I have a pulse factor as a factor. And the time, we are basically preparing here an alarm. And this is basically all the controller does is that it calculates one alarm based on the length of the remaining time of another alarm. And here you can also see what the pulse factor does. So the alarm length is either 60 steps multiplied by the pulse factor. So a higher pulse factor means longer blinking blinking pulses, and the smaller, yeah, the shorter the blinking pulses will be, and the duration. So it always takes the smaller one. So if there's not enough time left for a whole pulse, then it gets set to this one. Right, and then we set two alarms. Alarm 0 is set to ceiling of 0.2 multiplied by time. Alarm 1 is the duration. And yeah, those factors here, this whole timing for the blinking, it took quite a bit of trial and error on my part, because I wanted to really capture this classical game feeling, like just how it feels in the old classic games. And yeah, I think I found it quite well. So yeah. We return the blinker, the ID of the object, just in case you need this. If you don't even know why you would need this, then chances are that you will never need this. But yeah, anyway. So yeah, that's already the script done, which we need. Okay, cut. Typo over here. Very bail. Of course, it's variable string. Okay, back to you, Alex. And now all that's left is the controller object. So here it is. OBJ blink FX. I tend to add FX to all effect controllers for my games. Because, yeah, it's kind of handy to have this. So, we use... So, we start by defining one little variable over here, because this one is always active, not active, but always meant to be there. Boolean does blink is true. And then we will just, yeah, get into the other things. Let me get some space here. So the essentials. Boom, boom. And all those undefined ones are going to be used by, or not used, but filled with the script that creates this instance. Or this object of an instance. bum, 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 bum. Duration. And another thing you see, undefined. So I like to group my arguments always in like blocks, which makes sense. Like this is one block that makes sense for me. This is a second block and this is a third block. I can't really explain this. It's just how I roll, but I think you can deal with this. Okay. Now in the step event. Where is it? Here it is. In the step event, we check if the owner because the variable owner holds the owner ID or the ID of the owner object, and because if there's no owner object to blink, then we can as well, we might as well destroy the instance. Okay. Then we create an alarm zero. Let me copy and paste what I have prepared because I'm lazy, but really. So yeah, we blink the variable here in this alarm. Alarm zero does this, and we basically switch between true and false, one and zero in this case, and calculate the other alarm, or like we renew alarm zero depending on how much time of alarm one is left, and alarm one will, we will do this afterwards, which is, so alarm one is basically the whole length of how long the instance is blinking as a whole, and alarm zero is the actual blinking, the actual pulse, like being visible or invisible, or one and zero. So this kind of thing. So we do a simple switch. So this is another handy little trick, which you should know, but some people don't know it. So it's always good to mention this. If you have like a Boolean, one or zero, true or false, you can always switch between those. If you set them to not the one they are. So not is, no, is the exclamation mark. And if we set, we set here does blink to not does blink. So if it's true, this switches it around, so it's false. And other way around, if it's false, then it's not false, so it's true. So that's what this does. Very, very handy little thing to know. We use another local variable, LMM time, ELM time, alarm time, which is 60. And if alarm get one, so from alarm one, if that one is bigger than zero, if the alarm is still running, then time is the remaining time. Basically, that's the same thing we did in the script already, so we repeat this. False factor times 60, or yeah, so it's the smaller one, either the remaining time if this is smaller, or our standard pulse. And we set this alarm again. Sorry, 0.2, not 0.2. time. And that's alarm zero. Now comes alarm one. And this one is pretty simple as well. So this is just the final, what should we call this? The final countdown? It's the final countdown. No, so this is like Once this alarm is done, then the whole blinking is over. So what we do in the end, we set does blink to the end var, like whatever it should be in the end. You know, if it should be zero in the end, it would be pretty stupid if it would end on a one. So if it, in other words, if it should end up invisible, it wouldn't make sense if it would be ending up visible, right? Right. So that's what we're doing here. And just to make sure that we don't try to set a variable of an instance that doesn't exist, we check for the owner. Otherwise the game would crash, but yeah. So variable instance set. Now we set the variable owner variable string, which we have to use because we can't set a variable of a string we don't know otherwise. Blink. And we set, why not, the other alarm to -1 so that this doesn't interfere. But we are, just to make sure, you know, as I said, as I said before in other videos, I'm German. And we Germans are like, we like to double check, triple check, make sure things are really working out as how they are supposed to working out. Yeah, so that's that. And we are almost done, because what follows now is the end step. And this is basically which we do every step. We check and set the owner's variable to whatever the blinking value is at that point. So basically it's just the same we did in the last alarm. So instance, we check for the instance, for the owner. And variable instance get, no, not get, set owner variable string does blink, boom. And that's basically it. Yeah, so let's look at this in action. So we have our object test here. If we press escape, then yeah, the game ends and we add two more. So key press letter I for invisible and key press letter V for visible. So invisible, image alpha 0. So we simply blink this variable. So here's how you use our nifty little script. So blink ext. You look down here, it says arguments we have to supply. So the variable we are going to blink is image alpha. We copy this, and just as with the tweening system, we have to supply this as a string as well. This is just how things are working, which is, you have seen this instance variable set. It uses a string, and yeah, so we supply that string. It should have its string and the end variable. So in the end, if it's invisible, it should be zero. Image alpha should be zero at the end. And the duration, how many steps do we want to have this blinking? How about 180 steps? and pulse factor, because it's optional. We don't need this. This defaults to 1. We copy this one and put this into key press V to make it visible. And all we have to switch is 1. So this would be blinking 3 seconds and then be 1. So let's check it out. Okay, and here we are in the game. Now let's press I. And what do you know? It's blinking, and it's blinking faster and disappears. Now let's press V to make it visible. And it does just that. Invisible. Visible. Awesome. So let's play around with this a little bit. So what we do now is, we just to show you how this works, the pulse factor, as I said, if we use 2, that would make it the pulses like twice the time, double the length. And at the same time, if we make it half the length, so this should flash faster. So invisible longer, visible faster. Let's try it out. And here we are. Press I for invisible. See, slower and visible, faster pulsing. Yeah, simple as that. Then we can, of course, play around with the length. So only 60 steps here. To make it invisible, so it appears, it disappears faster than it appears. Let's go crazy and make it like 240 with very long pulses. So, yeah, quickly disappears and slowly reappears. Kind of like that. So that's that. Okay, so easy thing, pretty easy. However, as I said, it's a very cool effect. It's a staple, it's a classic, it's something you really should have in your repertoire as a game maker. And yeah, happy to having been of assistance to you guys. See you until then. Take care, have fun. Show me what you are doing with this blinking stuff. I'm curious to see it. So yeah, make sure to comment. And yeah, bye bye. Today's Saturday, at least for me, today when I'm recording this. So screenshot Saturday. Tag me in your screenshot Saturday if you're doing something with the blinking, or with something other I have shown you, like with the tweening or whatever. So anyway, bye bye, ciao.